A long time ago, over in the old country, there lived a fellow there in France that didn't amount to much. He was a juggler. He couldn't read or write. He'd go around following these little country fairs and do his tricks. Maybe make a few pennies. That's all he knew how to do. His name was Barnaby. He didn't have a last name. And even though this Barnaby didn't know much, he was a wonderful juggler. He'd start by balancing a tin pie plate on the end of his nose, and then he'd stand on his head and juggle 6 gold-colored balls in the air. And still standing on his head, he'd juggle 12 sharp knives and catch them with his feet. Boy, the people would applaud and throw pennies onto Barnaby's carpet, and at the end of a good day like that, he'd kneel down and thank God for his pennies. Those were the good days, the summer days when the sun was shining and he could make a few pennies. But in the winter, Barnaby had no place to sleep. He'd drudge along these old country roads, maybe sleep in some farmer's barn. Now, one year in France, they had this terrible winter. And one cold, wet day in November, Barnaby was walking along this country road, rain running off his face and off the end of his nose. He saw something moving ahead of him. It was a fine, fat mule. And on top of that fine, fat mule was a fine, fat monk. And when the monk saw Barnaby all covered with mud, he called out, "It's going to be a cold evening. Why don't you come spend the night where I live in the monastery?" Barnaby said, "Will they let an ignorant fellow like me?" And the monk laughed, "Of course, friend. Are we all ignorant compared to the Lord?" And the monk pulled Barnaby up behind him on that mule, and he had to hold both arms around that monk to stay off. And they laughed as they rode down the road. Well, that night, Barnaby was at the table in this huge dining hall of the monastery with all kinds of good food for everybody. Of course, Barnaby sat down at the foot of the table with the servants and the beggars. He stared around at the candlelight shining in his eyes. He had never dreamed of seeing such a wonderful sight, this side of heaven. He jumped from his stool, ran to the head of the table where the Lord Abbot sat, and fell to his knees. "Please, sir, let me stay here. I can never be a holy man, I'm too ignorant. But I can work. I can clean the stable, mop the kitchen floor. Please let me stay." And they did. Barnaby worked, scrubbing the kitchen floor, polishing the big copper kettles, carrying huge bundles of fodder for the cattle. And when the chapel bells rang for services, he'd creep in by a side door, kneel down in a dark corner in the rear. And all through those days, his face was just a shining with happiness. Till 2 weeks before Christmas. And then I guess you'd say, a bewildered expression appeared. Every monk was busy making a wonderful gift for the chapel on Christmas Day. Everywhere Barnaby looked, all these educated, trained men were creating beautiful gifts for God on Christmas. Paintings, music, sculpture. Poor Barnaby. He'd go to his room and think, "I'm just a rough man. All I know how to do is a few tricks. Everybody has a gift to give but me." Well, Christmas morning came. And the sun was just a-shining. The great stone halls were decked out with pine branches and red holly berries, and the building rang with music. The great chapel was filled with worshipers, and the wonderful gifts were presented. But Barnaby had disappeared. That evening, after the worshipers had gone and the chapel was deserted, all the brothers were resting. That plump, jolly monk that had brought Barnaby to the monastery, He went running down the hall to the abbot's private room. He shoved it open the door, grabbed the abbot by the arm. An awful thing has happened, the most terrible sacrilege ever to take place in a church. The two elderly men went running down the corridors, burst through the door to rear the chapel. The monk pointed a trembling finger down to the altar. The abbot said, "God forgive him, he's gone mad." Down below, right in front of the altar, was Barnaby. He had spread out his old carpet, and kneeling reverently on one knee, was juggling 6 gold-colored balls. He was presenting his old act, the silver knives, the shining balls, and on the tip of his nose, a tin pie plate. The abbot cried, "We have to grab him and drag him out of here." At that exact moment, a dazzling light filled the whole chapel. A brilliant beam coming directly to the altar where Barnaby knelt. Both men fell to their knees. For as Barnaby had finished his juggling act, they saw an angel. She came to where Barnaby knelt, reached down, took the hem of a white robe and gently dabbed the perspiration from Barnaby's face. The light dimmed and the angel was gone. The monk said, "God has accepted the only Christmas present he had to give." The abbot said, "Blessed are the simple in heart, for they shall also see God."